Hello friend, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 Metric. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_047_DIABM where you save it. You can also download this file on the website, or if you don't have access to the exercise file, just sit down and watch the video. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon. This will bring the save drawing as dialog box. Rename this file to 00_048_DIABM and click the save button. Go to the home tab, layer panel and click the freeze command. Select the roof to freeze the roof. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, layer panel, click the down arrow and select the cabbage layer. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. At specify starting point prompt, click at this endpoint, move the mouse cursor and click at this endpoint. Move the mouse cursor and click at this endpoint. Turn on the polar tracking on the status bar. Snap into this point. Type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command. Start from this endpoint. Click, click, click. Type C to close. Press enter to close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command. Start from this point, this point, this point, this point. Type C. Press enter to close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command. Start from this corner. Click, click, click. Type C and press enter to close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command. Start from this corner, this corner, this corner, this corner. Type C. Press enter to close the figure. Press enter. Start from this corner, this corner, this corner, this corner. Type C to close the figure. Press enter. Type C. Press enter to close the figure. Type C. Press enter to close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command. Click from this point. Click. 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 Type C, press enter to close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command. Start from this point. Click, click, click. Type C, press enter to close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command. Start from this point. Click, click, click. Type C, press enter to close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command. Start from this corner. Move the mouse cursor and type in this direction and type 150. Press enter. Move the mouse cursor and snap to the perpendicular object snap. Snap to this corner. Type C. Press enter to close the figure. Select this polyline. Click this vertex and move it into this area. Press escape. Go to the home tab. Draw panel and select the 2D polyline command. Start the polyline from this corner, this corner, this corner, this corner. Press enter to end the command. Go to the visual style control, click the realistic and select 2D wireframe. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. As specify offset distance from type 150, press enter. Select this line and offset it out. Press escape. Now select this line, right click, select similar. Right click, isolate, isolate object. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. I specify start point prompt. Start from this endpoint, this point, this point, this point. Type C on your keyboard and press enter. Press enter. Start from this point, this point, this point, this point. Type C, press enter to close the keyboard. Press enter to repeat. Start from this point, this point, this point, this point. Type C, press enter to close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command. Start from this point, this point, this point, this point, this point. Type C to close the figure. Press enter to repeat the command. Start from this point, this point, this point, this point. Type C to close the figure. Select this polyline and erase. Use a cursive window to select this polyline. Hold down the shift key and select this polyline. hit delete on your keyboard. Select this polyline, click on this script and snap into this corner. Press escape. Go to the home tab drop panel and select the line command. Turn on the auto mode. Start from this point and move the mouse cursor snap to this direction. Press escape. Go to the home tab modify panel and select the offset command. I specify offset distance from type 150 mm and press enter. Offset this line inside to this line. Press escape. Now go to the home tab, draw panel and select the 2D polyline command. Start from this point, type C, press enter to close the figure. Select these lines and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this line, click on the script and use the perpendicular object now to snap to this area. Click on this script and snap to this endpoint. Press escape to get out of the command. Now use a window selection to select this polyline. Hold down the shift key and deselect these lines. Go to the 3D tools tab modeling panel and select the extrude command. I specify extrusion height point. Type 560 mm, press enter. Select the solid, right click, select similar. Go to the home tab layer panel and move them to the 3D walls layer. Press escape to deselect the object. Go to the visual side, click the 2D wireframe and select realistic. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the home tab layer panel and click the fill layer button to bring the roof. Now we need to do some extrusion in the cable area. Select this solid and this surface, right click, isolate object. Go to the 3D tools tab modeling panel and select the press pull command. At the select object or bounded area point, hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button. Zoom in into this area and click on this face. At specifying height point, move the mouse cursor and snap to the endpoint of this surface. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the home tab, draw panel, click the down arrow and select the 3D polyline command. I specify first point, click on this area, move the mouse cursor and snap to the endpoint of this surface and this surface. Press escape. Now select the polyline that you just drew. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel and select the slide command. At the select object point, select this solid, press enter, type S on your keyboard and press enter. At the select surface point, select the surface. At the select solid object to keep or keep good point, select the bottom surface. Select the surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Now we need to close this gap with a wall. Select this surface, right click, isolate, hide objects. Go to the visual side control, click the down arrow and select 2D wireframe. Select this polyline, click on this vertex and move the mouse cursor snap to this area. Select this polyline. Go to the 3D tools tab modeling panel and select the extrude command. Move the mouse cursor into the Z direction and type 6000 mm, press enter. Zoom out. Go to the visual style control, click the 2D wireframe and select realistic. We need to extend this surface outside 750 and this face 750. Select the surface, right click, isolate object. Right click the UCS, select the face option and click on this face. Press enter. Now go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. Start the polyline from this point, press enter. Go to the home tab modify panel and select the offset command. I specify offset distance from sub 750 mm, press enter. Select this line and offset it in this direction. Press escape. Now go to the home tab modify panel and select the trim command. Press enter. Trim off this line. Hold down the shift key and extend this line. Press escape. Select this line and explode. Select this line and explode. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press Enter. Fillet this line through this line. Fillet this line through this line. Press Escape. Select this line and hit Delete on your keyboard. This line and hit Delete on your keyboard. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the 2D polyline command. I specify start point from this point, these points. Turn off the auto button on the status bar. These points. Press Escape. Select this line and hit Delete on your keyboard. Select the polyline. Right click. Polyline. Close. Select this surface and hit Delete. Use a crossing window to select all the objects. Hold down the Shift key and select this polyline. Hit Delete on your keyboard. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Surface panel, and select the Plan command. At the Select First Corner Point prompt, type O on your keyboard and press Enter. Select the polyline, press Enter. Right click the UCS and select World. Right click the drawing area, Isolate, End Object Isolation. Now select the surface. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Mirror command. I specify first point of mirror line. Zoom in into this area and use the midpoint object snap. Snap to this midpoint. Go to the status bar and turn on the auto mode. Now move the mouse cursor in this direction and click. Press Enter. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Surface panel, and select the Trim Surface command. At the Select Surface or Region to Trim prompt, select the surface. Press Enter. At the Select Coating Curve Surface or Region prompt, select this surface. Press Enter. At the Select an Area to Trim prompt, click this area. Press Escape to get out of the command. Zoom out. Go to the Visual Style. Click the Realistic and select 2D Wireframe. Zoom in into this area. Select this surface and this surface, this surface, this surface. Right click, Isolate, Isolate Object. Change the visual style to realistic. This surface need to meet with this other surface. Now to solve this problem, go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the line command. Start the line from this point to this point. Press Enter. Start the line from this point to this point. Press Enter. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Fillet command. Select this line and this line. Select this line and hit Delete on your keyboard. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, click the down arrow and select the 3D polyline. At the Select Object prompt, use the endpoint of this line, click, move the mouse cursor and snap to this endpoint. Zoom in into this area and snap to this surface. Move and snap to this endpoint. Hold down the Shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit. Snap at the endpoint of this surface. Type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Select this surface, hit Delete. Go to the 3D Tools tab, Surface panel, and select the plan. Press Enter. Select this 3D polyline and press Enter. Select this surface, click on this point and snap to this point. Press Escape. Go to the Quick Access toolbar and select the Match property. At the Select Source Object from, select this object. At the Select Destination Object from, select this object and this object. Press Escape. Change the visual style to 2D wireframe. Select this surface and hit Delete on your keyboard. Go to the visual style, click the 2D wireframe and select Realistic. Right click into the drawing area, Isolate, End Object Isolation. Now select this solid. This solid, right click, Isolate, Isolate Object. Select this solid, press Enter. Now go to the Home tab, Draw panel, select line command. Start the line from this point, turn on the auto mode. Move the mouse cursor in this direction and click, press Escape. Go to the 3D Tools tab and select the Press Pull command. Select this face and press it down. Press Escape. Select this line and hit Delete. Right click, Isolate, End Object Isolation. Hold down the Shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit. Now select this solid, this surface, right click, Isolate, isolate object. Right click the UCS and select world. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the press pull command. At the select object or bounded area prompt, click on this face. Now move the mouse cursor and snap to this endpoint. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the slide command. At the select object prompt, select the solid, press enter, type S, press enter, select the surface and click the solid. Now go to the home tab, draw panel, quickly download and select the 3D polyline command. At the specified first point prompt, click on this area, turn on, move on in this direction and type 750 mm, press enter, move to the positive Z axis and click, press escape, press enter to repeat the command. Start the polyline, the 3D polyline, from this point to this point and this point. Press escape. Select this surface, right click, select similar, right click, isolate, hide object. Now go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the 3D polyline command. Start the 3D polyline from this point to this point to this intersection and move down, click, press escape. I click the UCS and select the face option. Select the face of this solid and press enter. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the 2D polyline command. Start from this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint, this endpoint. Type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Select this figure. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Extrude this figure inside. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. Select this solid, press enter, select the solid and press enter. Select this line, hit delete on your keyboard. Select this solid, go to the home tab, layer panel, move this solid into the 3D world layer. Press escape to deselect. Right click the UCS and select world. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Now select this surface, right click, isolate, hide object. Hold down the shift key on your middle mouse button. Go to the visual style control, click the realistic and select 2D wireframe. Select this polyline. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Move to the positive Z direction and type 560. Press enter. Select the 2D wireframe and select realistic. Now select this object and this object. Right click, isolate, isolate object. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the press pull command. Select this face and click. Move the mouse cursor. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Snap to this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the union command. Select this solid and the solid. Press enter. Right click, isolate, end object isolation. Alright, I think the roof, the gable and the article is complete. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the isolate command. Select this, the cabbage layer, and press enter. Use a window selection to select all this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, layer panel, click this down arrow and select the previous command. Go to the view control, click the custom view and select SA isometric. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. Alright, we're going to end this video at this point. In the next video, we'll start to build fisher boat for our roof. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial and all the other tutorials on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.